the more relevant your content is to a specific niche, or niche as we say in the UK, the more likely you will get backlinks from that niche. So wouldn't it be great if you could identify specific niches where you already have a presence? Identify niches where your competitors are strong or weak. Create content targeted at specific niches within your overall market, so your chances of success would be so much higher. You can do all of these tasks easily with the topics filter in Site Explorer. I'll show you how in this video. Every business serves multiple niches, and this is likely to be reflected in your backlinks profile. But most people have an imperfect view of the niches they serve, but you can use topic filtering to find them. Let's look at Warby Parker, a great example of a site that serves multiple niches. I go to the backlinks tab, then choose topic, and a drop-down menu appears. This shows the major niches in which Warby Parker has a presence. So you can see Society and People, 211 backlinks. Recreation and Travel, 155. Business, Marketing and Advertising, 148, and so on. Now, the purists among you might think these links are irrelevant. That might be true if the backlinks are random and unconnected. But if the backlinks are meaningful, so there's a clear reason for the backlink, then they're natural. And you can use them to discover real niches and backlink prospects that you would otherwise not have thought of. Let's investigate by digging deeper into the topics from which Warby Parker get links. And we'll infer why those links were given. So on the drop-down menu, click on any of these topics and the filter will show only the top links within that topic. Here's the result for Society and People. As you can see, all the results are from that niche. Let's pick out this link from theartofmanliness.com. We can see that Warby Parker gets the link because they sponsor a podcast on the site. Oh, and you can also download all the backlinks in this specific niche. So let's quickly explore examples from the next seven topics and look for the reasons why the link was given. Next, Recreation and Travel. And I find this link from Downtown Madison. As you see, Warby Parker gets the link because they're supporting a local shopping event. Understanding the reason why the link was given gives you great insight into Warby Parker's approach to PR and link building. So that's my first task from my introduction. Identify specific niches where you already have a presence, even if you don't know it. Put your domain into Site Explorer and then use the topics filtering to dig deep into niches. And here with the topic Business, Marketing and Advertising, we find a backlink to Warby Parker from the Marketing Insider Group. This link is given because of the quality of content that Warby Parker create. In Reference and Education, Warby Parker get a link from the Carnegie Mellon University because one of their staff is interviewed in this article on an unconventional career path. Next, in Arts and Design, they get a link from a design blog because the writer of the blog was inspired by a quote from one of Warby Parker's founders. Why are glasses so expensive? Exploring why the link was given covers the second of my tasks. Add your competitors to Site Explorer and dig into the topics they get links from. The reason the link was given is usually obvious. Now, can this inspire you to do something similar or even better? Let's look again at Warby Parker. In computers / internet, they get a link because they applied a technical innovation to a pretty mundane task, the task of publishing an annual report. So they developed a tool that allowed customers to create their own Warby Parker annual report. Finally, let's look at recreation and food. This link here from the Hitchcock Restaurant press page, where they reference a post on the Warby Parker blog. Now look at the post, and we see a creative approach to content. A story about the chef, Brenton McGill, on how he sources the best food for his restaurant. Warby Parker published customer stories, and not because they're about glasses, but because they're inherently interesting stories. Warby Parker's blog has simple sections to see, to read, to buy, to meet, and to do. And that creative approach covers the last of my three tasks, but the one with the most scope. Create content that is targeted at specific niches within your overall market. For me, this quick look at Warby Parker has implications for what we see as relevant. It's not about a simple definition, yes or no. It's much more subtle than that. If there's a meaningful connection between the source and the target, then no matter what topic it comes from, that's a good backlink to have. If you've enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. And remember, you can check out our plans and pricing at majestic.com. And if you want to be among the first to see our new material, you know what you got to do. Hit the subscribe button. See you next time.